Okay, you may want to go down this pathway here of creating a, I don't know if you want to call it a false bottom sort of thing in this thing here, but let's bring this back it over. As I said, this bucket here has at least 600 cubic centimetres of salt in it, I think, as I said. As I mentioned before, with potassium amended salt solution, Saracini can handle up to seawater strength. Helium 4 can handle even more. And the question I have is, with the Mexican pinguiculus, is it? Because have you noticed, you never see a photograph of Mexican pinguiculus sitting in puddles of water, something. Now, Mexican pinguiculus can handle chalk, something. Because my suggestion to you is, as the salt index goes up, they have the worst of handling ability of salt. Of course, that runs in tandem with cyanophyta, of course. We'll see how we go. You might want to, as I said, you might want to do this. It makes the pot exceedingly a lot lighter, because as the moisture goes through your peat from your rain, and if you're watering by hand from above, like you water it once a day or a couple of times a day, depending. I mean, we have hot summers here. We have like 46 degree days in the third band, about the third week of February. So, you know, cut us some slack if we have to water more than once during the day. Yeah, the late morning, early afternoon, sort of thing. Every 2 to 3 hours maybe, if it gets really hot, we can have a 48 degree day or something like that. So I think that's about the height one. I mean, if it doesn't always come up to the brim, you can always put some charcoal down there, like with this one here. Oh, you can see that. Look at the colour on that central bit there now. Wow, that's really taking on some colour now. But yeah. So they can definitely handle that. You can see that one there. It's not dead, it's not keeling over, so, you know. As I said, the amount of pushback I had in the early days, and other people did too, we've all got to pat ourselves on the back, fellas. there were definitely two pathways. Now, what you want to do now, before this runs out, I'm trying to run it, is you want to put a substantial amount of tissue paper on the side there, sort of thing. Sort of like that, sort of thing. And do it like that, sorry. This also saves you, yeah, because this stuff is dirt cheap, you know. It's like $8 a bag, you know, $8 for 500, and it has advantages. Makes the pot lighter, which may be a bit of a trouble if you're in a windy section of the country or something. You might want to find ways of holding it down, sort of thing. But as the water goes through, of course, it has the easy water technique, so it generates reductive flammable gas. And because the hole in the bottom is small, it also absorbs some of the moisture over time. So the polystyrene does actually dampen up a bit, and then knits together, so it doesn't really move. You know, after a couple of months, it knits together, so it doesn't really sort of move or anything. So basically, you get something, some arrangement like that, and then you just start putting some of your stuff around the side gently, you know, like this, around the side, you know, a handful at a time, like this. Yeah, make sure, and you want to push it into the sides when you get going, because you don't want any of those beads coming up. You want to make a nice rim there, holding it in there like that. And I've got about 1/3 poly in with that, so that again, that cuts down on your medium, and also because the polystyrene is a different pH to the peat, it allows organisms that don't like the acidity of the peat to be able to grow on the surface or slightly inside the ones that's like a, it's a neutral pH with a, if you've got true polystyrene. So, as you can see, it's not as hard as you think it needs. You think, oh geez, I can't balance this stuff on here, it's going to fall through, blah blah blah. But no, there's ways and means, as you say. Ways and means. And then you just start, as I said, start building up. And when you, once you've got the this covered up, you can then start to put some pressure down on it, sort of thing. But only once you've got it covered up, sort of thing. Yeah, once you've got the this stuff covered up, you can start doing the centre, and then you start to put some pressure on it, and it will not collapse or anything like that. So we're rapidly starting to fill it up and sort of thing. And as I said, you know, this will have half that jar. So this will, this pot, when it's filled up, because it's half the thing, will have 300 cubic centimetres of true, real salt in there. But of course, as I said, you know, Sarracenia can handle up to, you know, true seawater strength. There are places in the United States where they're known to be inundated by the open ocean and survive. So it was all a load of bollocks, people, just to